There are cars, and there are legends. Everyone has their dreams, but precious few make them happen. You broke the mold, and they all followed. A rebel, some would say. You took the risks, broke a few hearts, but they still always will. Luck, you make your own. Never believed in fate. What was that you used to say? If you're not winning, you're not trying hard enough. That takes passion, nerve, spending a little time on the edge. Guts, it's in your blood, undiluted. Charm, in your DNA. Determined, an understatement. Your spirit can't be tamed. Who else can play with fire but keep their cool? Call it a day before you're satisfied. Never, and you'll get away with it every time. You always knew where you were going from the very moment you unleashed your soul. You fueled imagination. There are cars, and there are legends. Lotus, that's what drives you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for coming. I know there are plenty of other distractions, plenty of other things to see here at this Geneva show, but you will be rewarded for your patience, those of you who've been waiting for some time. You'll have seen a huge development in this stand over the years. If you are a regular Geneva show attender, you'll see how this whole stand has moved on. Lotus has always had a great tradition, a great name, a great history, and there is now a new ambition and a group looking for new challenges, and this is reflected in the stand, as you can see here, all these cars. The trend is continuing in 2012. It also helps us first, may not have music, but Lotus Group do have a Formula One world champion who will be racing in the iconic Lotus colours, and we'll be meeting him very shortly. But first, I'd like you to welcome, please, the Chief Executive Officer of Group Lotus, Mr. Dany Bahar, the man behind this transformation, his vision inspiring. Morning, Dany.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I would like to thank you for giving us your time today. I know you're all very busy with a lot to cover, and I appreciate the interest you have in Lotus. Allow me to begin by being a little philosophical. The words we just heard in the movie represent the spirit of Lotus. They were originally created as an internal staff motivational tool and never intended to go public. But they are so powerful that we wanted to share them with you. And one particular sentence of the founder, Colin Chapman, sticks out for me. If you're not winning, you're not trying. And boy, this company has had some trying times. Just look at the battles fought since its foundation in 1948. There were tragedies on and off the racetrack. There was death, there was fraud, and there was jail. But there were also glorious victories and some legendary road cars. In short, there was never a dull moment. But through all these years, one thing remained for Lotus, the true fighting spirit. Why am I telling you this? Because it applies to our current situation now more than ever. The takeover process of our parent company, Proton, hit us at the worst possible time, and I'm sure it won't surprise you to hear that we are struggling to keep the momentum going. I can assure you, though, that our journey continues and we are 100% focused on the delivery of our targets, both now and for the future. Right, enough of the sentimental journey. Actions speak louder than words. So, please allow me to introduce you to our newest driver.
Ladies and gentlemen, please
first up is one of my favorites. exist as water. A special car combines mesmerizing performance enhancing of the exigence with open air experience that makes you feel even more connected to the road. Throws a concept 6-speed that manual gearbox must also be available with Lotus Zero Precision Shift SPS that can operate an automated manual transmission, which we believe will make life more relaxed in the city, but even more raw and have fun life when it's let off the leash. Speaking of F1 here, it's also the Lotus F1 team, Evora GTE. We presented the original GT back in Frankfurt. Now I'm really pleased to tell you that the homologation process for Europe will be finalized very soon. With this exclusive edition, F1 fans can enjoy an extra special drive experience. An unpainted high-gloss carbon fiber body, a carbon interior with copper inlays, gold pipe, black leather bucket seats, and Lotus F1 Team Limited Edition badging. Believe me, this is about as exclusive a sports car as you can get. At this point, I would like to thank you to Mr. Mansouri for his help in creating this car. The GTE is not only the most powerful production Lotus Group car ever, it's also a perfect link to our motorsports ambitions for this season. Which leads me on to the next new arrival and the latest addition to our racing lineup. The Lotus V8-powered Lola design LMP2 prototype racer. This beautiful car will take on the challenge on the 2012 World Endurance Championship. Our LMP2 partnership is the ideal next step for Lotus as we climb the endurance racing ladder, having returned to the GT class last year with the Evora. On a personal note, I can't wait to see how it performs at Le Mans this year. I also can't wait to see this year's IndyCar races. Lotus will supply no fewer than 4 teams and 5 cars with engines. 2 cars will even compete in the iconic black and gold livery. The Indy 500 will be a real highlight for us, as our close friend John Lacy comes out of retirement and makes his debut in oval racing to compete for Lotus in the most famous race car, race in the world. Not only does he have our full support, but he has the added bonus of the support of the exclusive Swiss watchmaker FP Joe. By the way, if you want to know which watch John will be wearing in Indianapolis, you can see it in our lounge area on the first floor. At least he'll have no excuse to be late for practice. Speaking of partners, I need to say a big thank you to our many, many friends, supporters and suppliers who remain loyal and true to us during this challenging time. They continue to remind us why you believe so passionately in the incredible Lotus spirit and the potential of the brand. I've been told to keep this short, so I can't list all the names, but I would like to say a special thank you to Petronas, our official lubricants and fluids partner, not only for motorsports, but now also for road cars. This brings me to the pinnacle of motorsports, Formula One. I'm really very proud to say that finally there is only one Lotus name on the grid, and that's the official Lotus F1 team. And we're looking forward to an exciting and successful season in beautiful black and gold.
I'm all on board, and I'm ready. I'm Kimi, Raikonnen, and I am back.
Yeah.
is Kimi Raikkonen back. He is here in Geneva. Please welcome the 2007 Formula One World Champion, Kimi Raikkonen. Back in the sport for his 10th season. 18 wins, 35 fastest laps. Only Michael Schumacher and Alain Prost have gone faster and done more. Good morning. Now, what a lot of people may not know is that you drove here this morning from Zurich. How long did it take?
It was around 3 hours, a little bit of traffic, some accident on the road. But it was okay today.
You obeyed all the speed limits, of course.
Yeah, in Switzerland you have to. you get the trouble, otherwise with the police. But it's a motorway, but like I said, the small traffic jam. And it's a nice road to take with.
Out of interest, how much time do you spend driving a supercar or just driving anywhere? Because that's your job. Do you enjoy it? Do you like just getting out on the road somewhere?
Not for no reason, really. I mean, most of the time I drive from home to airport and from airport to home. So, especially in Switzerland, of course, in the races, it's from hotel, airport, circuit. So we don't really drive anywhere if you don't have to. I mean, there's no point to driving around. But that's where I spend most of the time, to go into airport at home. So.
But it depends what car you drive. Let's just put this one over here. Lotus F1 Evora GTE. What do you make of this? You looking forward to this as a company car?
Yeah, I mean, I have one of those ones now. So it's a slightly upgraded one, I think. It looks nice. I mean, it looks nice with the carbon finish, and it's very rare. I think only 5 will be made, so would be nice to try it one day and hopefully get one.
Have you got room in your garage for one? How many supercars have you out of interest?
I have, I think, 4 at home now, but I have some.
Okay, well, the chief executive, Dany, Bahar, is listening. Let's move over here, because this is the car which most of us are going to associate you with. This is the Lotus F1. How exciting is it to be back at the wheel of one of these cars?
It's very nice. I mean, if I wouldn't enjoy it, I would not have come back. But I enjoyed it, come back. Very good fun in the testing with the team.
We can hear you.
Yeah, just had a small issue in the test with the car, in the second test. But the team has solved it, and we are back and running, and the car seems to be pretty okay, so we'll see how it goes.
What was it about Lotus which made you thought, I'm going to come back to Formula One? The Lotus name, the people?
I mean, there was a few options, but in the end, everything worked out very well, very easy with the Lotus. And I mean, everybody knows the name Lotus in the motorsport, especially the color, black and gold. It's nice to have the same color than in the past and the same name, big heritage in the sport. Unfortunately, it doesn't make any faster, but it's a great to be under that name and race for Lotus, and hopefully we can do well.
You have been rallying, for those of you who don't know, he's been out of Formula One. You've also been doing a bit of NASCAR trucks as well. How has your career or your driving developed, do you think?
It's completely different sport, like rally and NASCAR to Formula One, but I think any driving helps. It improves in many different ways, and it doesn't harm you. I mean, at least I did something to race, and you have to be very sharp in both series, and I enjoy that. So now it's back to more normal thing in Formula One. Should be a bit more easy, because at least I know what happens in Formula One, and in the rally at NASCAR was completely new, so it should be a bit more easy to come back.
Things here. Tires. Michael Schumacher on his comeback found problems getting the most out of them. How easy have you found out on your comeback?
I only have had 4 days, but so far has been okay. And I think it depends a lot how the weather is, what circuit it is. The tire is actually not too bad when they are new. They are quite nice, good grip, but then of course they worn out a bit more faster than maybe in the past. But the one good thing is that I don't have very close experience with any other tires, so I don't really compare it to anything else. I just drive as well as I can with this and get used to it, so maybe in that way it's a bit easier. And, but so far it has been good.
You had a great time in rallying. I was wondering, would you like a party in a forest or in Monaco? Is it rallies better for parties than Formula One?
Well, like I said, it's different. I think Formula One is a bit more closed in the paddock and the people, and okay, the paddocks are different. The rally is more open, and everybody, the drivers, they can go out together more. And then to be more a friendship style, because you don't really race against each other. You race against each other, but it's not the physically, so it's a bit more maybe open and more friendly.
You were top of the timesheets in Barcelona. How representative that is then for the final test, the final day before the first race the weekend following?
I don't know. Nobody knows. We don't know what the fuel loads the others are running, what they're doing really, but the car feels quite good for us. We could have gone faster if we wanted, but it's no point to guessing. We know in 2 weeks, less than 2 weeks, what will happen, and hopefully we can be up there and fight for good points, and if not podium, we'll try to do the best we can.
Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, Kimi Raikkonen, nice to have you back. I know there are going to be some photographs here and also some interviews, written press and TV. But wish you well, Kimi Raikkonen, back in Formula One and for Lotus as well. Thank you very much for your attention.